Hello, and welcome back to the GCV Digital Forum. It's wonderful to see so many of you for our third iteration of this program. My name is Christina Ribaldi. I'm the executive producer of this program and for some of the other GCV events that you have may have had the recent experience in joining. I'd like to thank all of our esteemed panel members, keynote speakers, supporters, partners, and participants for dedicating their time and commitment to this virtual meeting setting. It's clearly not ideal, but it is working. And it does allow for CVC community members to come together and speak openly and freely and collaboratively around best practices and strategy. And with that being said, it's my distinct honor and pleasure to welcome to the stage Paolo Babai, who is the head of corporate venture capital at Henkel Adhesive Technologies. Thank you for being here, Paolo. Anyone that knows me knows that I love a great storytelling segment. I love a case study. I love an opportunity for someone to do a deep dive and a drill down and a demonstration on what works in terms of their CVC approach. And so thank you for being here because you're actually one of the only ones we have as part of our program today. So we're so excited to see you for coming from Germany. Thank you for sticking around. I know it's late for you there, but we're excited to hear what you have to share and contribute to our program today. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Christina. It's a pleasure to be here. And as much as I also would have preferred to meet you all in person and you know to actively network with you in person, I'm happy that we do that now digital and that we do it and you know that we don't need to postpone that to I don't know when. So happy to be here. Thank you very much for having me. And I would like to talk about how in Henkel Adhesive Technologies, startups also can help to strategically develop large corporates. Of course, in Henkel Adhesive Technologies, we also have the desire to grow into new markets for Henkel. And we differentiate between mature new markets and emerging new markets. In mature new markets, of course, there is no room for corporate venture capital. Here we do it with this M&A in order to enjoy immediate revenue potential there. But when it comes to emerging new markets, this is more an innovation task. This is really more something where we have to learn about these markets and where we have to find a way how we get a foot into the door. And this is where corporate venture capital in Henkel Adhesive Technologies comes into play. So what do we do? Why do we want to enter emerging new markets through CVC? So first of all, we would like to learn about the opportunity in new markets. Of course, you can read a lot of market reports and you can talk to a lot of people, but I think the real learning is hands-on learning. You really need to do things yourselves. And investing into startup companies and joining startup companies in those new markets is the ideal learning opportunity for us. It's also a relatively low financial involvement compared with a full-scale acquisition. You know, startup investments, as you all know, are relatively cheap. So we are kind of de-risking the market entry. So we would like to really discover new revolutionary technologies very early on and be part of those disruptive technologies. In the end, it could, you know, end up with an acquisition of a startup company. It could end up as an acquisition of a larger company, who knows. But in order to find that out, we basically view the venturing phase for a new market as a kind of extended due diligence. So the idea really is to also incorporate breakthrough technologies from startups into new business models. And I have an example here with me, which I would like to explain a little bit more in detail. But before I do that, let me do a step back. So what's our mission in Henkel Tech Ventures? The mission really is, in the end, to build a new Henkel business, which is based on the technology of a startup company. And based on a technology of a startup company, which Henkel could not have built alone or built themselves. That's really the idea. So we go into the startup scenes, identify, establish, and scale breakthrough innovations, in our case, in the field of advanced materials and technologies, together with our operating business. It's always a partnership between the startup and our operating business. So, and this actually also leads into the first objective. So we have three objectives for our group. The first objective really is that we are the matchmakers and connectors. Actually also we finding the startups. So we also identify them. We look every year through 3,000 startup companies in the material science area or in digital business models related to materials, and bring them to our operating business. And we then check if they have interest and if they would like to move into a collaboration. So we are really these matchmakers and connectors, and then also the facilitators of these collaborations. We also do technology scouting, of course, making sure our technologies are always top notch. And the third point, also very important for us, doing corporate venture capital, you of course learn a lot. And we are a team of 8 people, and it's certainly nice that we learn a lot, that we look at super exciting new technologies, meet super exciting and brilliant people. But it would be certainly better if we would share these knowledge gains also with our colleagues in the operating business. And this is the third bullet point. So as I mentioned before, the search fields which provide us guidance and also focus in our work is, first of all, scalable technology platforms. This is new engineered formulated materials. So it's not chemistry, it's really formulated materials. It's new business models which are related somehow to material science. And then we are supporting our internal incubators, which is in the moment printed electronics and 3D printing. If you would like to learn more about our search fields, please visit our website, henkel-tech.ventures. And one of the new business models we are looking at in our work is predictive maintenance. And I would like to explain a little bit the collaboration approach we are having with that example, predictive maintenance. We have in Henkel Adhesive Technologies a quite decent business on maintenance, repair, overhaul, MRO, these little red Loctite bottles, which you hopefully know, but this is more reactive and preventive maintenance. We now would like to make the step forward and do predictive and maybe even prescriptive maintenance going forward. The differentiator in doing that is, first of all, data analytics, but also proprietary unique sensors. We can't develop either one. So we cannot develop any AI, and we cannot develop any sensors. So we are looking for startup companies who are helping us to build that solution, predictive maintenance solution, for our customers. And we then incorporate their technologies into that solution. So how does that look like? So you have, first of all, the data collection from the sensors on the equipment, and then the signal from the sensors going to an edge device. The edge device is sending the signal to a cloud, and then in the cloud is happening the data analytics, the AI basically, so an algorithm which is driving conclusions from that data. And these conclusions are then shown on a dashboard to the maintenance engineers. It's also providing alerts to them and specific recommendations how to, for example, repair a pump which the system thinks is going to break down in 2 months or 3 months or something like that. So it allows the maintenance engineers to basically move the repair of that pump into a ordinary turnaround and preventing any unexpected downtimes. These sensors, as I said, are basically located on the different equipments, and it's not a one sensor fits all solution. So you need for different equipments, for different tasks, also different sensors, and this is why we are also looking for different startup companies. One of the startup companies we recently invested end of last year is Filet Technologies from Israel. They provide very thin, flexible printed sensors. You see here on the picture, Gadi Convaline, the CEO of Filet, applying actually the sensor, gluing the sensor on a pipe. You have here a kind of win-win situation. So as I said, we could never have developed that sensor technology ourselves, but we need that sensor technology to make a difference in predictive maintenance in the market and to also have a unique predictive maintenance solutions for our customers. So of course we benefit then from having Filet in our ecosystem, in our portfolio, but also Filet benefits because we have in Henkel adhesive technologies, 130,000 customers. We serve in a B2B business directly and 2 or 3 million through distribution. So there is also a huge and very broad customer base they could never have developed in such a short time frame themselves. And we offer the access to that customer base so they can scale much faster and better with our support. So it's a win-win situation. We both benefit from that. As I said earlier, these technical and digital business models are very important for us to move Henkel Adhesive Technologies into new business models and new future, and that future would not have been possible without companies like Filet. So they really help Henkel to strategically develop into these new markets. So what do we think is important in a startup collaboration? First of all, we need to build an interface with the right people. Not everybody in Henkel Adhesive Technologies is born to work with startup companies. So we had to pick the right people and then build those interfaces to also help the startup to navigate through the Henkel organization. We also need to align expectations and create transparency. Otherwise, it will be frustrating for both parties. We need to be super clear on the expectations and on the milestones we have for each other. So they have expectations to us, we to them, and this both needs to be on the table. We should set a common goal for the collaboration, of course, with milestones and measure then the progress along these milestones. We should always also emphasize a near-term impact for the company. Otherwise, if you tell them in 5 to 10 years, this will be a super nice opportunity and super nice business, they lose interest. They also would like to have some impact near-term, but the main impact then comes, of course, longer-term. We strengthening these collaborations, of course, selectively with investments, but we don't pretend what we are not. So we don't pretend to be a financial VC. We don't pretend to be agile like a startup. I mean, we have a very strong culture in Henkel Adhesive Technologies, and that strong culture is also not necessarily bad. I mean, it brought us to where we are today to build a 10 billion euro business, but it's important that we always realize who we are and what we want and how we can generate as a CVC value for our parent company Henkel. We learned a lot by screening the different sensor companies in this example for predictive maintenance applications. And of course, as I said earlier, it's nice that we learned a lot, but we really would also like to that our colleagues participate in these learnings. So we really believe that the learnings we are making really belong to everyone in our organization, our operating business. It also helps us to make better decisions and get different perspectives from them because we talk with them frequently, get their insights and their opinions, and that's always very helpful. And it's also challenging the status quo of what we are doing, and always forcing us to improve what we are doing constantly, which is also good. We have basically three different tools developed how we let the colleagues participate from these learnings. So one is the Tech Venture Seminar. In these seminars, basically, it's webinars, so it's a video, and then we have a kind of Q&A where we can engage with our people from the operating business. This is more, you know, knowledge transfer to them. In Tech Ventures Lab, it's a little bit different. There we have a platform where they can look at startups we think are exciting to share with the operating business. So we basically enter like 50, 60 startups every year into that platform. And our colleagues from the operating business can also add startups themselves. And then we have Tech Ventures Week. This is then one step further. This is it was in last November, unfortunately, also an online event. The idea is to have that even at least partially also in person, where we bring them closer to startups, where we select 12 startup companies participating also in the Tech Ventures Week, along with our colleagues from the operating business, and bring our colleagues closer to these startups, that they first of all experience what does it mean to be a startup company, and secondly, to also discuss in detail their technology, their business model, and so on. And we also have keynote speakers there and panel discussions where we hope that we can inspire our colleagues. We now have a little video which should show you and give you some impressions from the last Tech Ventures Week in November last year.
Hi, my name is Grant, and I'd like to welcome you on behalf of the Henkel Tech Ventures team to our first week of Henkel Tech Ventures. I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Paolo Nispoli.
You trust in the other, but the others need to trust you. People were actually trying to make mistakes, and they will raise their hand and say, hey, I made a mistake, I made this mistake. The organization was actually rewarding the people that they were doing mistakes.
And we're going to talk to Paolo Bavai, the Director of Venturing and Scouting at Henkel Tech Ventures.
I'm so excited about our Tech Ventures Week, where we bring our colleagues closer to startups, where our colleagues can talk to startup companies from our collaboration and investment portfolio.
Today, we're going to welcome 12 startups as they pitch us why they're the next step in innovation for Henkel.
When we talk about collaboration, it's not just that we come as a team together, it's about breaking boundaries. You have to have a collaborative culture and really drive it to the full extent.
We are trying here to build a community around our corporate venture capital activity. And each community needs a symbol, a visible sign. And our symbol, our visible sign, is the SOX.
I'd like to welcome Francis Arnold.
It's important to explore, right? To explore new ideas and do different things in order to look at those and to take some risks.
Machine learning, any kind of data-driven science is empowering discovery tremendously. So these technologies go hand in hand beautifully.
Pioneers at work. It was really energizing. Now I'm very much looking forward to see how this pioneer exchange translates into additional value for our customers. Very nice event.
Everybody got great insights and inspiration on how and why to collaborate with startup companies and on innovation in general.
Collaborate to innovate.
This is your deal team. They have an important responsibility, leading your company into the future of your industry. They source hundreds of valuable opportunities each year. Problem is, all this information is stored in Excel spreadsheets and silo systems. This leads to confusion, duplication of efforts, missed opportunities. In other words, valuable time wasted. What you really need is a reliable way to source, manage, and report on strategic opportunities automatically, all from one hub. And that's exactly what you get with ProCedar, a centralized platform for all of your corporate development activities. ProCedar is integrated with research databases to automatically populate information on the opportunities you source. Our system drives operational efficiencies by automating your workflows and tasks, reducing manual data entry, and providing transparency for your organization. Our collaboration tools allow you to have opportunity-specific, permissioned communication channels with internal and external stakeholders. ProCedar creates one system of truth to manage data and collaboration, rapidly configured to each individual case. And because our software is so adaptable, it means you get to execute on the best deals faster. Get your team on the same page, working from the same playbook. Connect with us now for a trial and to discover the full value of our corporate development platform.
Ways to save on auto insurance.
Really?
Yep. Very proud of that.
With Smart Ride from Nationwide, they can get discounts for safe driving.
Does she get one?
Mrs. Carmichael, safest driver in Peytonville. Takes a lot of work and effort to be the safest driver in Peytonville.
What about this guy?
With Nationwide Smart Miles, the less he drives, the less he pays.
The list of inspiring stories goes on and on.
I bet. I've never seen anyone do more with their retirement than you.
I concur.
Welcome to the 2021 GCV Digital Forum. This is a collaboration between GCV and ProCedar.
We're really focused on helping large companies disrupt from the inside out, which is creating, building, and launching new ventures that are generated from within and building their own incubators, and what we're calling disrupting outside in, which is helping them do world-class kind of corporate venture investing.
You need to have someone who really understands the parent company, but you also have to have someone who understands venture.
When we started TDK Ventures, we decided to be looking at a fund of $50 million. Mac 49 has really been helping us to understand what are the details that actually really matter versus the ones that don't matter.
That has been very helpful because even myself, that I'm coming from outside Schneider, I'm not an expert on VC. And there are ways, there are best practices of what works and doesn't work. So I'm learning from the experts.
Coming here from Meatpacking New York in our offices, blocks from Samsung, Facebook, Google, PayPal, the Denton's Venture Technology Group is excited to be partnering with GCV during its Digital Summit. The Digital Summit is particularly meaningful for us as a firm, given our focus on representing corporate strategics worldwide. Whether you're investing from London, Frankfurt, Shanghai, or LATAM, we're excited to engage with you.
This is the 2021 GCV Digital Forum pitch event.
I think the GCV Institute is extremely important because it's from the heart of corporate venture capitalists and teaching other corporate venture capitalists. And the great thing about the Institute, it's about learning. And one of the things I've always done in my career is continue to learn from others and really from the specialists that are out there. And I'm actually looking forward to the courses as well to see if I learn something new, because that's really what it's all about.
One of the greatest things about the Institute pilot program was the ability to hear from others in the market of how they are planning and strategic aligning with their parents. So really understanding what has worked, areas that we could focus on as an organization, and we'll be implementing a lot of the ideas that we learned from the program.
The GCV Institute goal is simple: to be a valuable, practical, and insightful professional development program for corporate venturing teams all around the world. I look forward to be part of an amazing hand-picked team building quality insights and best practices around getting new CVC programs up and running. By raising the bar in corporate venturing ecosystems, we will all serve better entrepreneurs, deliver on their dreams and their potential to impact the world.
I'm really proud to be part of this program because GCV has always been a leader in corporate venture capital education, and I think that this program that focuses on business development is critically important for the long-term success of a corporate venture capital program.
I'm super excited to be part of this program, as I know how much growing pains involves starting this program and learning from your own mistakes, and having opportunity to learn from people who have been there and done that can not only improve our how efficient we are within our organization, but it can also significantly improve our standing in the overall VC community.
I want to thank the Global Corporate Venture Institute for this initiative. It's critical for our team to have resources to both train new members as well as to help us evolve our model, incorporating best practices from the corporate venture world.